like doing all this other stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get this started. Okay. Hey, welcome to the Kick Six podcast. We are back with Coach Kirk Broussard and myself, Tracy Lynn. Now, it's not the best way to start a show, but it's a topic that we have to acknowledge right now, because right now our hearts are broken. And it doesn't matter what side of the border you're on right now, where you were in the world, Monday Night Football, the world stopped just under 6 minutes into the beginning of the game. And we all saw DeMar Hamlin go down. And it's something you really, I practiced this because, you know, I have been talking about this for the last, since this happened last night. But it's all over social media, Coach Kirk Broussard. Our world stopped. It doesn't matter if you're a Bills fan or not. Your heart broke. It wasn't about football. It was about a man's life on the field. And we still don't know. A lot of speculations, a lot of sources saying this is what's caused it. He went into cardiac arrest. It took like 10 minutes. They worked on him to get his heart going. The players built a wall around him so that his family didn't see who were in the field. We didn't see what was going on. This is a moment that's changed football. Now, this has been the season where not only have scores been unpredictable, but these injuries. What are your thoughts on this? Because, you know, one could say the real pandemic right now is not the COVID that's going around or a virus. One could say that this pandemic actually has to do with our athletes, their mental health, and their bodies shutting down right on the field. What are your thoughts on what happened last night?
You know, first I want to say my condolences go out to his family, his teammates, his coaches, all the people that are close to him that, you know, have a ongoing relationship with him on a daily basis. I know they're hurting. I know they need strength. They need prayers. So, you know, that's my first thoughts is how are they doing? You know, and then you look at it from the element of really the entire NFL. You know, they may be on opposite teams, but everyone's brothers. I mean, they're all in a brotherhood of a fraternity, a very rare fraternity that you can be an NFL player. And, you know, there's a lot that comes with that. And this is very unfortunate. And, you know, just going back, reflecting to last night and that moment, you know, with them trying to resuscitate him and you know, perform CPR, mm-hmm. you know, you just wonder. I listened to a doctor earlier today that actually has been analyzing this the impact. And he gave his evaluation of, you know, it's all speculation of
yes.
how he feels like, you know, what may have happened. And basically what he said was potentially it looked like he, you know, obviously he got a direct impact, you know, in the chest area. Mm-hmm. But he was saying how it's like once in a million for you to be able to hit someone at right. a very specific time to throw off the cycle of the heart, the rhythm of the heart. And it has to be on a very specific timing to be able mm-hmm. to send the heart into like what he called, I believe it was defibrillation, and I'm not a medical expert.
Yeah, but they said he went into cardiac arrest uh-huh. and it was like a fatal hit. Now yeah. It is day by day, they're saying with him. They have put him in a coma. He is drugged up at the moment. They put him so that his body can heal and they could see what this outcome will be. And I know that a lot of health experts are going and telling us the difference between a heart attack and cardiac arrest, because many of us, when we saw this go down, yeah. we watched this play happen over and over again, because initially we thought it was his head yeah. and it was a concussion and he went down. And, you know, we have to also say that we are thinking about the other players involved in this. This was not something that was, you know, intentional. It just happened. That's the game.
Yeah.
And 24 years old, as I said, this yeah. seems to be a common thing with our athletes.
Yeah.
More and more.
He's a perfectly healthy guy that's been like all through all protocols as far as health checkups and physicals, you know, so we know he's in the greatest shape possible. So I just think it was just really a freak accident, to be honest with you. And at this stage, you know, the doctor talked about him being in sedation. And the biggest thing that, you know, the doctor was kind of saying was, how long did his vital organs go without oxygen? And that's really going to be the deciding factor of how much damage potentially may have been done. And yeah, I think he was saying that he has to come out of sedation to be able to make those determining factors, it seems like, you know. So
yeah,
it's one of those things to where, you know, like you say, recently, you know, we are seeing a lot of our top athletes experience these unexpected health, you know, issues. You know, you saw the offensive lineman from Jacksonville passed right. away recently as well.
Yesterday, so, they reported that he had a heart attack at 38 years old.
Yeah.
38 years old. And now this is not just something that happens in football. This happens in all sports. Young athletes.
Yeah.
Their hearts are stopping. I mean, there's a lot of reasons why this could possibly be happening, but it just seems like it's something that we're talking about way too much. I mean, the common story for this season was all about head trauma.
Yeah. Yeah.
But
yeah,
yes, so. our prayers and our love definitely sending to everybody who has been affected by this, and to the Hamlin family and the Buffalo Bills family, and just everybody. I mean, the whole world stopped.
I want to give credit to the NFL emergency staff that they had on deck.
Oh, yeah. Because
they jumped in the action pretty fast, and they were really, you know, on top of everything that they needed to do to, you know, give them a chance to, you know, to bring him back and get him going. So, you know, hats off to the NFL. I think, you know, a lot, either way it went, they were going to get a lot of criticism. People were saying they took too long to make a determination about the game, and there was criticism from on both sides. But I think, you know, looking back on it, it's a situation that no one's ever been in, because I've been around football for 30 plus years and I've never seen anything like that. So, you know, I just think everybody's so quick to criticize today. I think the NFL did a great job with canceling the game and getting him the right medical attention.
You know, exactly, because they said it took about a good 9 to 10 minutes to get him stable.
That's scary.
And you have to think, I mean, we all saw coaches, personnel, players, all affected by this. They were crying, they were upset. So hopefully the NFL will step in and get everyone the proper help that they need to get through this and move through this, because
mental
this is
health as well. You
huge.
Know, you're right. To see that happen to a coworker right in front of your eyes, I mean, that's devastating. Those guys are going to need mental health assistance for quite a while.
Yeah, it's something. You couldn't unsee this. We were on this again. A lot of speculations. A lot of sources seeing things. There's nothing that has been confirmed yet. They said the first 24 hours were, as you even mentioned as well, was the most critical. So as soon as we get more information, we will pass it on to our audience as well. And that has that game has been postponed. Originally this morning, it was supposed to be played within 2 days. Now they're saying they're not going to be playing this week. So that was a good call. Because some Buffalo Bills came back last night, some stayed. So yes, as soon as we have more,
call it a tie and move forward.
Right. Right. But, we have to move along, and there's really no segue. There's no way that we can really move past that topic. But, like I said, we will keep everybody up to date, and we'll repost anything that we get from our sources, but it is the playoffs right now. Heading into week 18, nearly half the league has already been eliminated from playoff contention, while another select few teams have clinched their playoff seating. And prime candidates, for starters, can just rest a little bit. But we can agree right now, a lot of us are sitting back going, I'm sorry, who won last week?
Yeah.
Oh, first off, Giants. Yes, we'll do the happy dance. I know you weren't expecting it. I wasn't expecting it either.
I admit I was wrong about the Giants. I mean, that guy, he's came and turned it around, and wow. All you can say is wow. He's done a hell of a job.
Yeah, and there's a lot of, we saw the first half. Like, let's talk about Brady. He kind of was the joke of the football season of the NFL coming out of retirement, and how he performed, how his team performed.
Yeah.
And now, obviously, they're doing well. They're doing a lot better than anticipated, where we are heading into week 18. But interesting, you brought up a story about Tom Brady because, you know, one of our topics was talking about Tua and other quarterbacks that have, I mean, it's been injury after injury. Main topic, head trauma, concussions. We've seen that all throughout this season.
Yeah.
But you mentioned something that was rather interesting about Brady, and I'll let you tell this story because we were all thinking it, but we didn't know how to communicate it. And you say it bang on.
Yeah. You know, I just feel like, you know, it goes back to when Jordan played and probably before then. You know, if anyone can reflect back on when Michael Jordan played, there was a set of Jordan rules when it came to him getting fouled versus everyone else in the league.
Yeah.
And I would even say Gary Payton had a lot of that leverage too, because Gary Payton was very vocal. And I watched Kevin Garnett tell a story recently how Gary Payton would control the concession stand, the coaches, the opposite coaches, the players, the cheerleaders, and refs. I mean, he would back you down from baseline to baseline. And he would say, you know, watch his hand, ref. Watch this, ref. He would be instructing the ref on how to do his job.
Yeah.
And that brings me to Tom Brady. It just seems like with his seniority and his GOAT status, this seems to be a different set of rules when it comes to being a little bit cautious with the quarterback than the other guys get.
He's bubble wrapped. He is a bubble wrapped quarterback, as you said. Nothing ever happens to him.
The refs take care of him a little bit. I mean, it's obvious. You can see it. He's been 45 years, pretty healthy for at 45 years old, you know, and then you see these young guys that are taking hits.
Well, look at how many concussions are, you know, they didn't call it a concussion right away for Tua.
Yeah.
But the head injuries.
Yeah.
In one season, that guy has had what, three made. This is a third one, isn't it?
Yeah. I think you got to win a couple championships to get in that
to that level.
To get the refs to kind of protect you a little bit. So Tua's just not on that level. It's part of, you know, they do a lot better job with protecting the quarterback. And rightfully so, because if you didn't have these great quarterbacks in the game, no one would watch it. I mean, it would be a boring game.
Right.
So you can't play like we played in the 90s and in the early 2000s. You have to be, you got to keep, protect your quarterback. I mean, to make the game interesting. So,
well, I'm sure that Brady has trademarked the Brady bubble wrap. So
that's a great term.
the Brady bubble wrap.
You know, if you actually bubble wrap some Brady dolls, that would be a number one seller.
There we go. Yeah. I'm going to retire by the end of the show because I'm going to make millions of dollars off Brady. There's my love-hate relationship. Now, there is word that Brady and Gronk heading to the Raiders. There's a possibility of this. I mean, rumor, sources say there's this possibility that Gronk wants to come out because he's saying he's bored.
Yeah.
And he only says that when Brady is looking for help. Yeah. And we know Brady wants to move around. He's done with Tampa Bay. What do you think about them reuniting with the Raiders?
I like the idea. I like the move. I mean, Brady in Vegas, I can dig it. And, you know, they got this relationship with Josh McDaniel, you know, there. And I think it'd be a good fit. There's a lot of familiarity, obviously, with his offense. Mm-hmm. You know, and then looking back on it, I always thought they may have had some strife in their relationship, but I guess they're pretty tight friends, obviously, if he's considering going there. But, you know, you put Brady, you got Devontae Adams, a great weapon for him to throw to. And Brady, obviously, he's not Brady, you know, but he's still effective and he can still win games. You know,
He's had quite the personality in the last couple of years.
But he's had some talent drop off as well. I mean, he's not the young Tom Brady. He's not even the Brady we saw a few years ago. But he still is effective. He can still win games. And I kind of like that. You know, if they add some pieces in free agency in the draft to send him out there with Josh, I think it'd be a good fit. And I think I'd like to see him give that a try and ride off in the sunset with the Raiders.
Well, time will tell on that one.
Yeah,
now, week 18, we got to get to your picks.
Okay.
I mean, we can speculate. We know coming into week 18, expect the unexpected. if you think this team's going to win, you might want to go with the second team because they probably will lose. This is pretty much how it goes, right? Yeah. So I've done some of my picks.
Okay.
We've seen who's playing this week, and there's one in particular, and we'll get to that soon. A lot of people are saying there's going to be a huge upset this weekend. Yeah. A lot of upsets. But when it comes to on the Saturday game, we got Kansas City and Las Vegas. Who are you going with?
You know, these games are so difficult to pick because you have two things working here. You have teams that have already clinched the playoff spot.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe they're going to take their foot off the gas a little bit here. And then you have teams that have maybe playing for a higher draft pick that are going to take their foot off the gas a little bit, you know, so it's difficult. So you say KC.
Yeah. So there's Kansas City, obviously. I mean, they seem to be the go-to. They're definitely going to do this, but I could pick a few other ones. There's a few other ones I was very unsure about, and I would like your opinion on this.
I'll go KC.
Okay. Yeah. KC's obviously one of the most popular picks. Let's talk about the Tampa Bay and Atlanta game.
Okay.
I'm very unsure of this. I originally, when I did my instant pick, went with Atlanta.
Yeah.
But then again, it is Brady, and I expect the unexpected, and he's not going out a loser. So who do you think?
I'm going Tampa. Atlanta's playing for a high draft pick. I'm going Tampa. Tampa's catching fire here. They won last week, and I think they're going to go into the playoffs with some steam. I'm going to go to Tampa.
Okay. So we're different on that one. Now let's talk about the Bills. I mean, we really don't know what's going to happen. Who's going to be playing depending on the outcome of what's happening, but they are expected to play New England.
That's going to be a tough one. I don't even know if I can pick this one because where is everybody at mentally, you know?
Right.
I'm going to go New England. I don't think Buffalo can be mentally back. Unless they rally, unless they get some great news between now and then, and they rally behind them with all this motivation, and they go out and kick the crap out of New England, it's possible.
Yep. Okay, now this one here, Miami. We've talked about Tua really quickly. Yeah. I mean, obviously he's not playing because he's another injury.
Yeah.
They're playing the Jets. Now, I don't know. I originally went Miami because sources are saying close to me that I spoke to earlier today, that they're going to squeeze their way in.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to go Miami. I mean, the Jets just don't have it. You got to go Miami there, even without Tua.
Okay. This is one of my picks, that they're calling a big upset.
Okay.
I don't know. I might put money on this one. I don't know.
Okay.
Detroit and Green Bay.
Wow.
I feel like Detroit's going to do this. And, you know, this will be the last that we see of Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah. Where's that one at?
It's home for Green Bay.
I'm going to go Green Bay. Because Detroit is a dome team. They play indoors. Green Bay is used to being outdoors. Green Bay is a better team. Detroit is playing motivated. They've been on fire and motivated. I mean, their coach is doing a phenomenal job. Jared Goff can look like a superstar sometimes and look like an average quarterback or below sometimes as well. So with it being outside, being home, I think Aaron Rodgers is kind of bought in. You know, he seems to be bought in. I'm going to go Green Bay.
Really?
Yeah.
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 You just don't want like a hot second to think about it.
It's cold. It's cold right now. You're taking a dome team outdoors.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go Green Bay.
Okay. I'm not confident with Green Bay. You know, I don't know. Where do you see Aaron Rodgers after this season? I mean, we've seen how he is on the field and, you know, coach's perspective, you know, probably more by his body language and what he's saying.
He's so bipolar. You know, you don't know how he's going to be. I mean, sometimes he just gets in these funks where he just seems like he's so prima donna and he wants to be gone and he wants a new start.
Yeah.
But then he kind of comes back in and he wants to be the team guy and be all about Green Bay. So I think it's gonna depend on the success that they have finishing the year. Mm-hmm. I think if they make a strong run, like Super Bowl run, yeah, I think you could see him back. But if they don't, if they go like a first round exit, I think he's gonna be looking to get out.
And where do you think he'd go?
Well, there's a lot of teams that he would fit well with. I mean, when you look around the league, you know, you look
him as a player or him. I mean, you're dealing with his ego. You're dealing with his athletic ability.
Yeah.
There's only going to be so many teams that he actually fits that puzzle piece.
It's going to take a very specific coach to kind of control his ego, you know. Mm-hmm. So you look at teams like, you know, I would say the 49ers, but I don't know if Shanahan would want to deal with that. So here's what I'm going to say.
If they didn't want Brady, they're not going to want Aaron Rodgers.
You're right. Depending on who they get in Denver as a coach, mm-hmm. I could see, I mean, Russell Wilson just got there, but I think they're going to try again with the new coach with him. So maybe
Russell Wilson.
Yeah.
Biggest disappointment this season.
They paid him so much. He's not probably not going anywhere. So that's probably out. Wow.
But
the Saints. Yeah. The Saints. I could see.
Okay. It.
Yeah.
I was going to say the Saints because he seemed like he would fit good there. But let's circle back to Wilson.
Okay.
He is labeled as the biggest disappointment for this NFL season.
Yeah.
Can he come back from this? Do you see him coming back from this season?
With the right coach, yes. With the right QB guy, with the right QB coach, the right head coach, and the right offensive system, I could see him getting back on track to being a fringe Pro Bowl guy.
Yeah.
But it has to be the right system.
Okay.
And that system he was in, it wasn't right for him at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So is there a particular player that you want to highlight to say, yeah, I mean, I know that you had your picks at the beginning of the season and now looking at week 18, has your perspective changed on certain players and teams heading into week 18?
My perspective has changed so much on so many players and so many teams. It's wild, you know, but I really like, you know, if I want to highlight someone, I'm kind of proud of what they've done. I like what San Diego's been doing with the whole offense and the, you know, their coach, the defensive guy, but their offense is humming and they got Herbert, a hot young gun. And mm-hmm. I'm very impressed with the direction that they're going. So I would say San Diego would definitely be on my list as mm-hmm. someone else impressed me.
But any other thoughts when it comes to football getting into week 18? I mean, there hasn't been a week where there hasn't been a headline.
Yeah, I mean.
And unfortunately, it's the injuries that we keep talking about.
Yeah. I mean, Detroit is shocking the world right now.
I know.
I mean, no one expected this from Detroit at all. So,
yeah.
Well, I'm really curious to see how they're going to finish out and how things are going to go with them. So, I'm going to have a close eye on Detroit, Philadelphia. I'm going to be watching Philadelphia strongly as well. So, I mean, it's just the league is so unpredictable, man. We always say it's a soap opera, you know. So
it is a soap opera. I mean, it's a great soap opera, but I will tell you, you know, going back to the Bills game last night with Hamlin's injury, I actually felt guilty for being a fan and watching this sport or watching just being in love with sports in general.
Yeah.
I felt guilty because a player is fighting for his life.
Yeah.
And as we said at the top of the show, this is not about the game. This is about a man. This is about a man's life. And, you know, a lot of the players' arcs are talking about their injuries. I know we only have a few minutes left. And hopefully, you know, he's a fighter and they're saying he is fighting right now. So,
yeah,
I kind of felt guilty for being a fan last night.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, at this point, you know, it's out of our hands and,
mm-hmm.
you know, you just look at it and wow. I mean, I try to favor the good, positive news that I hear from some of the doctors that have given feedback. Mm-hmm. Because one doctor said today that, you know, it's possible he can have a full recovery. So, yeah. You know, you just got to be hopeful. And wow, I mean, he really needs a miracle right now. And there's strength in prayers. So.
So hopefully this will be the last of any injuries that we're talking about this season, because it's just, it's too much. Too many dirty plays, too many just hard hits. I mean.
You've stood on the sideline at a pro game. You see how violent it is. Everyone's so fast and strong and powerful. It's violent. So, but someone said today that football is one of the sports that has a 100% injury ratio. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just a matter of time. You're going to get hurt in football.
Right. Unless you're Tom Brady and you're wrapped in Brady bubble wrap.
Yeah.
Well, I better get to trademarking that. Well, everyone, thank you for hanging out with Coach Kirk Broussard and myself, Tracy Lynn, for the Kick Six podcast. And we'll see. Let's see what week 18 brings. I hope you guys have a great weekend coming up, a great week ahead. And we will meet back next week. Have a great week.
All right. You too. Thanks.
Perfect. There he goes. Cut the